welcome to another episode of the Boss Up Visual Podcast Show. It's your girl, Shakita D. Days, CEO of Derrick Denzel Days II Corporation, Executive Director of the Boss Up Visual Podcast Show. I am known as the Business Technician. Why? Because I help you fix your business. Just as simple as that. Now, I want to talk about the Boss Up Visual Conference. All of you that are on the fence of getting your tickets, free tickets are sold out. $25 tickets are also sold out. There's only $50 admission tickets left, and those are going to be limited soon because there's limited space and limited seats. Now, why the Boss Up Visual Conference? We've been around. We've took things from every organization, business, conference, and we put the total package together because we see what was necessary and what was needed for people to grow in whatever industry or business that they are doing or pursuing. So we wanted to make it clear that we had all the tools intact for everyone to be able to succeed, no matter what level you're on, no matter what level you're at. So that's the reason why we came up with the Boss Up Visual Conference, because we wanted to let people know that you are great. We want to teach people how to boss up, the average people, not only look like you're bossed up, but to actually live the life, the bossed up life. And bossing up is not, you know, only flashy things or whatever. Bossing up is basically making sure that you're financially stable, making sure you have your assets in order, like life insurance, you have your investments, whatever it may be. You have all your eggs in the basket. So that's what Boss Up really means, is that you got your stuff together, basically. So now I'm going to bring on Angela Amazing Tate, our co-host. She's going to come with you with her caregiver segment, and we're going to have a few commercials come in as well. So thank you guys for joining us. Take it away, Angela.
Hello, 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 everyone. It is your caregiver coach, Angela Amazing, the number one caregiver coach in the country. And I am here at Tropical Smoothie Cafe here in Houston. And I'm excited because I have a special guest today. I have Sharonda Thompson. And we are just sitting here kicking it. I'm excited about that. I pulled up on her. We're sitting outside enjoying the breeze. You know, with COVID going on, we want to kind of be extra careful. And so I wanted to interview her today, just ask a little bit and talk a little bit about her health and how she made some lifestyle changes that really, really caught my attention. So when she said, pull up and let's get a smoothie, I said, you know what? I know that this was intentional for me to connect with her. So I'm going to go ahead, and I can't introduce her better than she's amazing. She was a friend from years ago, a client of mine from back in the days. And when I tell you, she pulled up here in Houston when I got connected with her. And she's still the same person, of just a beautiful spirit. And, you know, sometimes we have people in our life that come and some people go. But then we have people that we remember why we love those people, why we like those people, and why we get these people access to our lives. And she's one of those people that I definitely, in this season, allowed access to me. Because we talked about denying access. Everybody who's with you is not for you. So everybody can have access to you. So let me not go on any further. Let me introduce Ms. Sharonda Thompson. How are you today?
Hi. Hello there. Hi, everyone. I'm good today.
So I'm so excited because when you told me that you had some health challenges and you changed your entire lifestyle, I was just like, oh, that's cool. But then when I started thinking about it, and thinking about what does that mean to have a lifestyle change, I wanted to get deeper into how does that look and how did you get to that point. But before we do that, tell us a little bit about your health challenges. How did you get here to Houston? And when did you decide that you were going to make a change for the better?
Well, first of all, I got here from here in Houston because of Hurricane Katrina, New Orleans, and I've been here ever since. But my health change came from me having congestive heart failure. So when I found out I had congestive heart failure, I had to change my way of eating and even exercising. So that's how I get on that path. So, but I mean, it's a big difference eating when you start to change over vegan, semi-vegan. It's a big change from eating everyday foods. So much is in the everyday food that's not healthy for us. There are so many different things that they put in the food. So you have to change. And so I wanted to live. And so that's how I begin to change the way I eat.
That's amazing. And I think it's amazing because we all want to do the right thing. And if you are a caregiver or if you are a caretaker, if you even know someone, sometimes when you are just a business owner, when you are that busy mom that's working from home, we don't have time to eat properly. But we got to make time. And I think I was a little overwhelmed because I felt like she, you know, connected with me in the right season because I made a conscious decision that I needed to make some changes being the caregiver coach, being the caregiver, and just being the woman who wanted to walk in being amazingly powerful. That needed to look different for me. So when I spoke to Sharonda, I was like, oh my God, my God loved me so much. He sent her because when she said pull up at Tropical Smoothie Cafe, I said, oh my God, who does that? Everybody's like, let's go eat. And just her way of living. So she said she had congestive heart failure. Tell us a little bit about that. And when did you get diagnosed with that?
I've been diagnosed with congestive heart failure for going on 4 years now. And at first, it was heartbreaking. For me, I was the type of person that just didn't take care of my body. And I was always the type of person that worried about everything. So stress, worry, not taking care of your body, not eating right, it causes those problems, you know. So, but now, also, let me just say that also I take natural herbs as well to help for healing.
Yes.
With congestive heart failure. So I take those as well because in the Bible to tell you that the Most High God put natural herbs on this earth for healing for us. So I take natural herbs for that. So anyway, I know for sure that if it wasn't for that, I probably wouldn't still be here right now. So basically, you know, trying to stay on the right path. I mean, sometimes I don't always eat like I should, you know, but I definitely try to, you know, and I'm heading back in that direction to just being straight vegan again.
I think you're doing great. I love the fact, and again, if you guys are just tuning in, we're sitting outside here in Houston, Texas at the Tropical Smoothie Cafe. So if you hear the little background noise, listen, we're enjoying, you know, just taking one day at a time. We're being transparent. We're just like sitting here and let's talk about it. Most of the time we don't make time to just even have a conversation with someone. We don't sit down and we don't kind of be intentional about holding the everyday conversations because we're too busy rushing. And we live in a microwavable society where everybody wanted fast, 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 fast. And that includes your weight, that includes your success, your business. But you know what? I'm going to be honest. This has been an awakening moment. I know her mom, her family, and right now her son is a caregiver. And I love the fact that he's a young male taking care of his grandmother. And it's very powerful for me, you know, and I'm looking forward to connecting with him as well because we do have men caregivers. We do have people that are sacrificing taking care of themselves to take care of others, you know. And I just know that hearing his mom's story, he's in a position where he's doing something life-changing. He's giving back. That's amazing. How do you feel knowing you've raised your son to be this man, and yet your son is stepped up? He's helping take care of his mom, probably was in a position taking care of you as well with your health challenges. That gotta make you feel amazing. Tell me, what do you think about how he moves?
Well, I think he will definitely help and take care of my mom. That's definitely a plus. I feel really good about that, but she also helped raise him too, as you know. We was all in the house together for years, but you know, I'm proud of him for that, you know. And I hope that, you know, I hope he continue to stay on that path, you know, continue to be the person that he is with my mother and everything. And I mean, she loved it because she feels so much comfortable with him.
Oh, wow.
Then, you know, then if it was a stranger.
I agree. You know, so, I agree. Yeah. And I definitely will reach back because I am, if you don't know, I am founder and owner of Amazing Caregiver Circles. And I am definitely going to move that into a different direction. I am starting my own caregivers magazine. So I am going to highlight a month where I highlight my men. So that is going to be this year. I am working on that. And he will definitely be one that gets a spread in the magazine. I'm excited about that because the reality is most people are so busy in their own world that they don't have time to take care and share for others. And just to see that, it's powerful. So if you're just tuning in, I am Angela Amazing Tay, the caregiver coach, the number one caregiver coach in the country. And I am sitting here with Sharonda Thomas. This is an amazing. We're catching up from old times, but her health and how she transitioned to become vegan, eating healthy after finding out she had congestive heart failure. But not only that, her son is a caregiver and, you know, taking care of her mom. So this was just like a double bonus interview. And I'm so grateful. As you know, we are getting ready for the Bossed Up Conference, March the 19th in Miami, Florida. We're excited about that. And this is the kind of stuff that I'm going to share. I'm going to share in some of my breakout sessions, some of the things we'll be talking about, how important it is to network, how important it is to reach out. Right now, people are going through depressions. They're going through health issues because they don't know what to do because of the COVID, because life's changed. So if you can relate, definitely drop in the comments or send something my way. Reach out to me. I am at Amazing Coach Amazing .com without the G. And you can find me on Instagram as I am Coach Amazing. And you can find me on Twitter as I'm Coach Amazing, Facebook, Amazing, Angela Amazing Tate, the caregiver coach. Or you can email me at Amazing Caregivers Circles with an S at gmail.com. So I just wanted to, guys, tune in. Thank you for being here. I am having fun with this caregiver segment. I do this weekly show because I want to bring a different perspective. I don't want to look like the world. I want to look like me. And what that looks like for me, because I tell you guys all the time, it looks different for everybody, is you pulling up and being yourself. I don't have to do it like everybody else. I pulled up in the cafe. We're sitting outside enjoying the view, the breeze. And you know what? I love it. I love it. So what do you want the listeners to walk away with about being scared once they get a diagnosis, not knowing how things are going to look for them? Because you've already experienced it. Yes. You've already been through it. You've already handled that part of been there, done that. And now you're walking into, I'm trying to be healthy, wealthy, wise. I'm just like walking in intentionally, letting the Most High lead me on my everyday journey. I love it. So what would you tell a listener who just got diagnosed with something, even if it was congestive heart failure?
Yeah. Actually, I would just say that the only way I got through it is definitely strictly the Most High God. Prayer, you know, having faith, learning to have faith, Because even at that time, I mean, my faith wasn't that strong. So learning to have faith and trust in the Most High God, because he have control over everything, every situation. So that's what I would say. I would just say, continue to have faith, stay strong, you know, take care of your body, you know, and just be positive, you know, think positive. And that's basically it.
I love it. I love it. Thank you for being here today. We are so excited to have you on Bossed Up Virtual Podcast, which is my sponsor show. And, you know, I'm excited. I'm excited because every day we wake up and we wake up to be better than we were yesterday. We wake up with intentionally trying to do the best we can. And sometimes we don't know what that looks like. But I think it just looks like what she just said. And, you know, tag somebody in this interview. Tag somebody, share it with somebody, because we're in this together. And I think some kind of way we are walking in this country in division. But we got to go back to the basics. We got to go back to connecting, sharing, loving each other, just kind of being grateful and walking in gratitude, you know? So I just wanted to share that with you guys. I'm not going to keep you. I hope you have an amazing weekend. Tune into our show next week because I'm excited. I have a special guest. I'm going to save it. We'll be talking about the Bossed Up Conference the closest we get to it. I am your host, Angela. Amazing. And remember, when you look in the mirror, you should see that you are truly amazing. And if you don't, you're probably looking in the wrong mirror. Bye, guys.
March 19th, 2022. You don't want to miss it. Everybody get there. Everybody be there. It's going down. It's going down.
Hi, my name is Shakita Days, and I am one of the CEOs of Gary Danzel Days, the second corporation. I want to let you know this Valentine's Day, your heart will skip a beat when you see just what Amazon has in store for you and your loved ones. Stop for your galentimes and valentines, your lovely pet, and also don't forget to treat yourself. Explore our most loved collections by Amazon.com. Celebrate love this season by sharing the number one wedding registry in the U.S. Amazon Wedding Registry offers the world's largest selections, including gift card funds, fast, free shipping up to 20% off their remaining registry items, and easy returns. So don't forget to treat yourself and treat the one you love.
Let's talk about economic empowerment and how bad company corrupts good character. The power lies in your finances. If you can learn the power of how money works, you can change the way you feel about life. Life shouldn't be hard at all. However, you have to be smart. Learn ways of life that will make life easier for you. Also, be careful of the company you keep around you. Why? Because bad company corrupts good character, and a negative mind can influence a free spirit. So watch your energy. Energy is real. How you feel is what you will attract. So make sure you keep your energy level positive and avoid negative people. Remember, good energy attracts good things, and bad energy attracts bad things.
Thank you for joining us with another episode of the Boss Up Visual Podcast Show. Do not forget to grab your tickets at Eventbrite.com. You create a life of fullness when you allow yourself to react and activate. Don't forget to stay bossed up. It's your favorite CEO and host, Shakita D. Days. Stay tuned and be safe. Have a happy, fulfilling new year.
March 19th, 2022. You don't want to miss it. Everybody. Everybody get down. Everybody beat up. Oh, it's going down.
Hoy despertamos en Miami.
Eventbrite.com. There's going to be food, drinks, so much fun. It's going to be so epic. So you don't want to miss it.